Now on BBC One Scotland, a big day in the football calendar. Here are the highlights in Sports Scene with Rob McLean.
Stand by for a Scottish football double bill, the story of the SPL weekend, plus highlights of today's League Cup final. We've a total of 22 goals to show you, and in the next 70 minutes or so, you'll hear from these two, Owen Coyle and Craig Levine. First up, Hampden and the battle for the first silverware of the season, St Mirren against Hearts. And for those two sets of supporters, a big day out. The streets of Glasgow came alive from first thing this morning.
Slipping the silverware into their trophy cabinet tonight. If St Mirren do it, it'll be the first time they have won the League Cup in what is their third attempt at the final. Defeats to Aberdeen in 1955 and then Rangers much more recently in 2010. The latter is still an open wound. If Hearts do it, it'll be the first time they have held both national trophies at the same time and the first time a team out with Celtic and Rangers have done so since Aberdeen did it in 1990. Coming just over 300 days since they lifted the Scottish Cup for an eighth time in that memorable hammering over neighbours Hibernian. May the 19th, 2012 will live on in Hearts folklore, while March the 17th, 2013 join it in the Tynecastle Roll of Honour. Captain Jim Goodwin declared himself fit in midweek, so returns in the heart of the Saints' defence. Gonsalves, McGowan and Thompson all scored in the semi-final win over Celtic. Darren Barr returns from suspension for Hearts. He scored the opener in the 5-1 rout of Hibs last May. Just three of that team featured that day. Danny Wilson was sent off in the final of this competition against St Mirren 3 years ago when he was at Rangers. The referee is 40-year-old Craig Thompson. This is his third League Cup final. He was also in charge of last season's Scottish Cup final. Michael Ngoo there scored the equaliser for Hearts in the semi-final against Inverness. Of course, they came through on penalties. He scored in that shootout as well. Ngoo made an impact in the semi-final for Hearts. That man, Ismael Gonsalves, made an impact 24 hours later, scoring the opener against Celtic in their last four matches. It's St Mirren to get us underway. The 2013 Scottish Communities League Cup final. Saints looking for their first League Cup triumph. Hearts eyeing up their third. And who would have thought they would be back here so soon when you consider the turbulence that they've experienced this season. It was November the 7th, the club issued that dramatic plea for help, insisting they were days from ruin after HM Revenue and Customs went to court over that unpaid tax bill. Yet from the rubble of their off-field problems, here they are back at the National Stadium, taking part in a battle they want to be involved in and where they want to be doing it. Billy Dodds with me. Very tight to call, isn't it?
Well, sometimes you can have an educated guess and there's reasons why. Maybe a strong defence or exceptional up front or a strong look in midfield. Maybe that extra man in midfield, but maybe a mistake will win it. This rain been falling in Glasgow today, still coming down.
And it's Stevenson back to Dylan McGowan. Well worked with Stevenson. It's in for John Sutton. And Craig Sampson had to look lively. And Now it's Taul, Hearts first really to threaten. And here they come again. Away by Goodwin. Stevenson is caught by Paul McGowan. Excellent play by Hearts down that right-hand side. McGowan, little give and go. Hits that front post area. Could they have just flicked it? Maybe been a bit harsh on him. Unlucky John Sutton never had the angle to just flick that one in. Long ball in. Sutton tried to get his head onto it. It's tossed back into the mixer. Danny Wilson was involved as well. Simon can't clear their lines at the moment. Steve towards Sutton Webster. Waved up there and it's charged down as well from Craig Sampson by Sutton. Well, Hearts look really up for this. Just all action, isn't it? We knew it would be frantic. We knew it would be pressing all over the pitch. Both teams trying to gain the territorial advantage. It's a slap one there from Van Zanten.
Newton to Teal. Teal perhaps will test McHattie. Can he get between the two, and he has done. Wilson came to meet him. McGowan goes for the little chip to the back post. Was it the right thing to do, Billy Dodds?
I think it's an excellent attempt. It's just that area I was talking about, you see, in between defence, midfield, when he peels. Don't see why not, he shouldn't be trying to find that far corner. It's a decent effort from McGowan.
Taul. Submitting bench, I think, wanted handball against the Moroccan. McHattie. Well, it was a very strong challenge on this near side on Sutton. Hearts will play on, though. It is Ryan Stevenson one way, then the other. What a Hearts! Ryan Stevenson puts the Jambos into the lead in the final. Strike across the bows of Craig Sampson. Hampden is maroon again.
First impressions, I think it's taken a little nick off and done it. It's two tackles from someone that free up Ryan Stevenson just outside the box. He twists, he turns, and I'm sure it's nicked, and it's an all-important deflection. We'll get a look at it here. It's two good tackles, two solid tackles. You see Goodwin here, right through and good. Now they've got a problem, one and one, Dummett. It's a turn, a twist, he's forced right. I'm sure it's taking a nick to take it past Sampson. We'll get a better shot from this angle, Liam.
Yeah, it's certainly taking a touch through. Ryan Stevenson twisting and turning in the edge of the area. Yeah, it did take a touch on its way through past Craig Sampson. Paul Dummett was the closest St Mirren player. It's a dream start for the Scottish Cup holders. He's been stung early on as the St Mirren gather. Hearts in recent years have been one of the best teams to defend 1-0. They really have. Quite solid at the back. They're missing, of course, Zoukas, who is injured as they press again. Jamie Walker. Well, John Sutton got the right side of Jim Goodwin there. Of a free kick, but that was another nervy moment for the Saints rearguard.
Yes, another chance. It all comes from Hearts pressing. I'm watching Sutton dropping onto Newton when Hearts don't have the ball. Then Walker applies the pressure. They nick it, the cross comes in, and tell you what, it's another chance. Just needs a connection. I think that could end up in the net.
All the second balls are going Hearts' way at the moment. It's Jamie Walker. Newton comes to meet him. Walker gets it in. What a cross it was, and the woodwork prevents St Mirren from going 2-0 down. Sutton's header.
Well, you said it's all about the cross from Walker. But Sampson ends up no man's land all over the place. And Sutton's in at that back post, gets himself off a Dummett. Oh, just the angle beats him, doesn't it? Look at this young lad with that delivery. Takes Sampson right out of the equation.
The sun beginning to break out over Glasgow's south side as the ball bounces off the arm of Jim Goodwin. Hearts free kick. he's smiling, but I'm sure there's a lot of irony in that. Jim Goodwin, things aren't going his team's way at all. Here comes the delivery, it's in good! Samson makes the save, and Goo didn't get anything on it. Had he done so, it would have surely been 2-0.
Simon, they're all over the place. Sutton and Ngoo getting himself free. That's two that's got to be picked up. Any connection takes into the net. You see here, Sutton's off of Goodwin. I think Ngoo's off of Thompson. Samson saves the day, but not good enough defensively from Simon. Great ball in as well, we have to say. I think that's a decent save from Samson.
Hearts leading through Ryan Stevenson. And now it's Mehdi Taoul, and they're on the counter again. Walker, Sutton and Ngoo wait in the middle. Walker teasing Vinzantin. Another break of the ball goes the way of Hearts. It's Taoul. That was tricky! It was unlucky.
Yeah, and I just think the pace has beaten that man Ngoo. It's brilliant from Taoul. You're talking about having that composure that Simon haven't had in the game. You can see him in the box. Lovely little turn, takes him away from Newton, hits a shot. Can Ngoo be gambling? Maybe just the pace has beaten him. Maybe I'm being unfair to the lad Ngoo, but I tell you, if he goes all out there, I think he might get a touch in that.
It's the second time these two teams have met at Hampden Park. The other was in the 1987 Scottish Cup when Saints went on to win it, beating Hearts in the semi-final here. Ian Ferguson opened the scoring that time. He would go on to score the winner in the Scottish Cup final. Gary Mackay cancelling it out. It was a late winner from Frank McGarvey. As Thompson finds Teo, who's onside. This is the big moment. Surely this is going to be 1-1. And is! They've been up against it. And Ismael Gonçalves hoists St Mirren off the canvas. Parity restored in the League Cup final.
Well, where's that come from? But it's been absolutely exceptional. It's all come from Gary Teo. The turn, the drive, just all excellent. Thompson turn, sorry, lays in Teo. What a pass that is. And then when he gets there, he could score himself, but so unselfish. Cup final, on you go. Gonçalves gets a tap in, son. Brilliant from Thompson. Look at that turn, look at that pass. So unselfish from Teo as well. Brilliant.
Salvage will try and win the foot race in McHattie, and he has won it. Back to Teal. Gonçalves is offside, but Teal isn't. Teal isn't offside. It was Gonçalves who was. Gary Teal can't believe it.
Maybe Gonçalves didn't realise, but just leave a second. It's clearly offside. Just his movement to the ball, that's when the flag is up. But I think a little bit unlucky there, Simon.
Well, there is the half-time whistle. It has been action-packed, and it was Hearts who drew first blood. Thanks to Ryan Stevenson, cancelled out by Ismael Gonçalves against the run of play. That means we're back to where we started at half-time at the National Stadium. It's St Mirren 1, Hearts and Midlothian 1. The 67th Scottish Cup League Cup final. Three of the last five League Cup finals have gone to extra time. That's where we'd go if it stays like this. If St Mirren win it, six different teams will have won the last six Cups in Scotland. Rangers and Kilmarnock in the League Cup, Dundee United, Celtic and Hearts in the Scottish Cup. Hearts started brighter, St Mirren came into it after equalising. Which way will it go? No changes for either team at half-time. McGinn. And Salvish. Up on McGowan. John McGinn. Simon slowly but surely coming forward. Dummett gets it in for Thompson! Second half, that is! The boyhood buddy, Stephen Thompson, fulfills a childhood dream! They have turned it round! From behind
St Mirren lead the League Cup final. Sensational.
What a turnaround, honestly. You just think St Mirren are just getting top on top at the end of the second half, and then they go and get this goal here. It's just allowed too much room in the left-hand side, Dummett, but it's all about Thompson's movement. McGinn picks it up, a little bit of luck, it goes through McGowan's leg, but just the movement getting across the front of Danny Wilson, and what a finish that is. Turned on its head, Liam.
Stephen Thompson, who is a lifelong St Mirren supporter, has put them back in the driving seat in this cup final. Salves, Paul McGowan. Goodwin. It's for Thompson. By Dylan McGowan. Stevenson. The real ebb and flow about them in the majority of the first half. Hearts are trying to get that back now. Very unlucky from Walker. Now, he is proving to be a real find for Hearts.
I've watched him a lot this season, as Rob said, on the right-hand side usually, but he's found himself on the left today.
Ngoo. Great challenge there by Van Zanten on Walker.
Yeah. He knows Van Zanten, they're young, they're quick, son. You get the wrong side on him, but he ain't going by, mate.
Jamie Walker's great uncle is a former Hearts manager who helped them win all four of their League Cups. This is Taul. Twisting and turning himself there. It's Taul and Ngoo! And somehow Samson keeps it out. Not that Ngoo knew much about it in the first place.
John McGinn will be breathing a sigh of relief. He gets caught in the ball, edge of the box. The composure of this lad goes in. Just McGoo doesn't know much about it. Samson does enough.
Ngoo waits again. McHattie's corner once more, and that's Ngoo again. Well, he is 6 foot six, but he couldn't divert that in target.
First press, he's got to score. Gets himself free. It's behind him, but just concentrate, keep it down.
Vladimir Romanov, centre of the picture, who's making a rare appearance. Probably the most colourful character Scottish football's seen in a very long time. Well, that's going to be a St Mirren ball as their chairman watches on. Stuart Gilmore, just in the centre of your picture there. St Mirren were up for sale for a while too, but doesn't seem to have moved any further forward since.
A long 34 minutes for him, I'll tell you.
And adjust. Unless St Mirren can get a bit of insurance here. Thompson spun away and he might get a second bite at it. It was blocked. Shout for handball, not given. It's McGowan. It's well wide. I can tell you, his manager, his head in his hands there on the touchline.
I'm not sure if it's McGowan or McDonald who gets the block. Probably a bit of both, a touch from McDonald, then McGowan does enough, comes back to the other McGowan from St Mirren. A lot of bodies here, sometimes it can take that deflection.
Another Newton. Gonsalves, Newton continued his run. Newton!
May well have won the cup for St Mirren! He's certainly given them insurance! And Connor Newton, what a time to get his first goal for the club in a cup final at Hampden Park! The cup is St Mirren's to lose now!
The standard of the goal from St Mirren has been absolutely exceptional. Connor Newton picks it up, goes past Doyle. Little give and go from Gonsalves. Hearts come up as a line. Wilson doesn't watch the runner, but Newton, it's all about him. The 1-2, the run, the composure once he gets here is brilliant, and he just lashes it home. Finish that as.
Connor Newton on loan from Newcastle. The St Mirren fans wouldn't have heard of him before he signed for the club. He teed up the first of the semi-final and he blasts St Mirren into a two-goal lead in the Scottish Community's League Cup final. much has been made of the players that Hearts are missing today, those who have left the club, but of course they've not been helped by the injuries long term to Danny Granger and Jamie Hamill. Jamie Hamill has missed the Scottish Cup final last season as well, almost a full year out, and here they come. That's deflected and Sam's supposed to be the Zibetin coup! It's blocked! Well, McHatty, the initial effort to submit in free kick.
Big chance for Hearts. See McCausland getting caught in here, that's what I was talking about. And then once McHatty hits the strike, deflection. Good save from Samson, good reaction.
There's a high foot from McCausland.
Big guns up, Wilson. Webster making their way.
Well, they need it to happen, Hearts. They need it to happen, and their fans know it. The Jambo Hordes. Watch on. Wilson wins it. Stevenson! And for the second time this afternoon, it is Craig Sampson's goal frame which saves St Mirren.
Wilson wins a header, I'm sure he does. Knocks it down to Stevenson. And I thought he was going to just smash it. You see Wilson here. Good knockdown. Lovely take from Stevenson. He tried to just lift it over him. I thought he was going to smash it. Maybe it was the right thing to do. Comes off the shin pad, really. Could that be the final nail in the coffin for Hearts?
At the moment, they're thinking about putting up the bunting in Paisley. Holt, Ngu, it's away there from Newton. It's a good run by Stevenson, and he's found him. Ryan Stevenson! In it goes! In it goes! The goal Hearts craved! Is on here at Hampden Park. Stay where you are. It's 3-2.
Well, it all starts off with the young lad Jason Holt showing composure to nip it into Ngu. And I'm thinking, get your head up, Ngu. Looks if that big head's down again, but releases the pass at the right time through the legs of Van Zanten. Sampson sees it late, can't do nothing about it.
This is Michael Ngu. Here is Stevenson, blocked, and again it's the post. Stevenson on a hat-trick.
Where did he find the energy from? Ngu just sort of getting the head up, he does again. That area, you think, not getting it through there. Stevenson, Sampson does enough to near post.
But St Mirren have the ball. They are so, so close to glory. Graham Carey, he's away from ball, dropped down. It's a St Mirren free kick here, and Craig Thompson books Andy Webster. The cup is looking like it's going to Paisley.
And what a piece of play that is from Graham Carey at this stage in the game. 93 minutes plus, he could have taken it to the corner, could have run out of the pitch, but it's a little nutmeg, and then draws the foul from Andy Webster. Webster picks up the book, and St Mirren can take all the time they want.
That's it! The long wait is over! St Mirren to silverware. There will be black and white ribbons on the League Cup tonight. It is making the short journey to Paisley for the very first time. Danny Lennon has guided St Mirren to one of their biggest triumphs, one of their greatest triumphs. A trophy drought of almost 26 years is over.
Can see how much this means to you. You've got tears in your eyes. You're history makers.
You know, this is, you said it, you know, it's a once in a lifetime opportunity to try and win a cup here, and you know, we've done it, and you know, we've made every one of the fans, our families proud, so can't ask for any more.
Party time now.
Yeah.
Paul, congratulations to the man of the match.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well, he wasn't sure if he was going to play in this match, Jim Goodwin. He did. And he was, again, colossal in the St Mirren defence. And he will join Jock Bradford in 1926, Davy Lapsley in 1959, and Billy Abercrombie in 1987 as cup-winning St Mirren captains. It's St Patrick's Day, and there will be an Irishman lifting the Scottish Community's League Cup.
a wonderful triumph, and one for them to cherish. St Mirren have won the 2013 Scottish Communities League Cup. The parties are in Paisley tonight.
Stephen, just how good did that silverware feel?
It's pretty much indescribable, really. Just seeing all these St Mirren fans here, and I've been dreaming about it ever since we beat Celtic. I'll not lie, I've not had a lot of sleep. I've been playing it over and over in my mind, been playing that goal over in my mind, and thoughts of things, and today it came true.
That goal was real Roy of the Rover stuff, wasn't it?
Well, I don't know. I made a near post run, and I was just so making sure I was really concentrating on getting a good connection with the ball, and when it went in, you'll probably see from my face, it was a very cathartic moment, shall we say.
When you knocked Celtic out, you had something in your eye. You really believed this was possible, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm working at a wonderful football club. It's an honour and a privilege to serve them. It's a club I fall deeply in love with every week. And you see what it means to them. Absolutely, absolutely terrific. And we're certainly going to enjoy the occasion. And this will live long in the memories of these players, the family, supporters. I'm delighted we've done it for Paisley.
Jim, sum that up if you can.
It's nearly impossible to put it into words, honestly. I was saying earlier, you know, you watch so many legends walk up them steps over the years, and you just hope as a boy that you're going to get the opportunity to do it. And, you know, I've fulfilled one of my many dreams today. Just such a proud moment to celebrate it with my family and loads of family over from Ireland. And, you know, St Patrick's Day, it's just a really memorable, memorable day, and it'll live with me forever.
A fantastic team spirit, this man here as well, I suppose, sums that up.
He's been great, he's come along, you know, and he's done a great job for us. I think he's enjoyed it, I hope he has. He won't get many occasions
amazing,
like this.
It's amazing, I'm really happy.
You're looking at that winner's medal, you're not letting go of it very soon, are you?
No, I'm very happy today. It's the first trophy, I'm really happy, it's amazing to be here.
Gary, I can see the disappointment in your face, it's very clear to see. What is the feeling in that dressing room?
Yeah, we're all deeply disappointed, you know. As I say, I thought when we went 1-0 ahead, we had a couple of chances after that to go 2-0. But really, we've got to try and, you know, score there. And really disappointed with the start of the second half. You know, we just never got going at all. First 10, 15 minutes, and it's cost us a game.
Talk me through the team spirit that exists at this club.
Oh, unbelievable. Unbelievable. I'm made up for the last because you can see how much it means to them. And the fans as well. I mean, they've came out on a day like this in their numbers. And it's brilliant for them. Absolutely magnificent.
Massive party tonight?
Yes, definitely.
Enjoy it.
Thank you very much, Finn.
Let's hear from Owen and Craig. It was a great final, wasn't it? And a much better final than I think most people expected, Owen?
I thought it was outstanding. I thought it was end-to-end. I think St Mirren had a probably slow start in the game, but the quality of the goals, some of the play, the chances, I thought it was a terrific advert for Scottish football.
The transformation in St Mirren was dramatic, wasn't it? At a point in the game, Craig, where it looked as if Hearts could have had the trophy in the bag.
Yeah, but you've got to score when you have the opportunities, and I thought the crucial moment was that goal just before half-time, and that certainly dragged St Mirren back into the game. It gave them belief going into half-time, made Danny Lennon's team talk so much easier in the second half. And they came out and they were a different team in the second half. I mean, you have to credit Hearts in the first half. I thought they were excellent and deserved to be a couple of goals, maybe three goals up. But that second half performance from St Mirren, you know, that was the one that won them the cup. You know, getting that goal late in the first half and then that second half
performance. Goal change games. I think we all realise that, you know, Hearts, had they got the second goal, I've got no doubts they'd been on to win that game. Very similar to the semi-final with St Mirren. Celtic missed the penalty. But St Mirren, whether you think they've rode their luck, fair play to them, they've dug in and they've come out with an outstanding performance. I mean, the quality of the goals, you know, you can't take nothing away from them. There was, you know, high level of play individually, collectively. And as I say, Danny Lennon will be absolutely thrilled tonight.
Yeah, a lot of good goals. I mean, not from both sides, I thought the goals were excellent today. And, you know, I was really thrilled to see that at the end of the you know, see Danny Lennon's really excited about his team winning. Great for Stuart Gilmore and the directors who've had a difficult time, obviously, trying to sell the club. And for the supporters as well.
It's that genuine excitement, isn't it, at a team that's not used to winning silverware. It's not a regular occurrence.
Well, that's what was great today. And I think the atmosphere as well. I mean, both sets of fans entered into it with a real belief that their team could be the winners in the day. And I think that's how the teams approach the game. You know, really going all out to, as I say, win the match. Pleasing in the eye, culminating in lots of goal-scoring chances. What we like to see as fans, entertaining football.
Well, Hearts look back on quite a lot of pluses out of the game. A young team, Craig, even though it's runners-up medals.
I think it's difficult to take pluses out of losing a cup final. You know, this one-off situation. You don't get to many cup finals, and it's difficult to use the experience of being there. It might be another 5 years before they get to another one. So, you know, they'll just be incredibly disappointed tonight. I mean, you can't fault them for their effort. I thought they were excellent. Their supporters were excellent. And somebody's got to win and somebody's got to lose. And unfortunately, it was Hearts that lost today.
You'll not be surprised to hear the St Mirren celebrations didn't stop at Hampden. It's all happening in Paisley tonight, from where our party correspondent Brian McLaughlin takes up the story.
They were formed in 1877, but until today, St Mirren had never won the Scottish League Cup. However, that has all now changed. The celebrations are starting here at Hampden. We're now off to Paisley to see what it's like in the town centre.
It's amazing to see the streets of Paisley lined with the fans, and we're going to have a hell of a night, let me tell you.
Stuart, you must be a very proud chairman this evening. Very, very. This is fantastic. I mean, look at the people in the streets. Absolutely fantastic. These guys have deserved it, you know. So it's been a long time coming, hasn't it? National trophies don't come that often to clubs like St Mirren, so it's been absolutely fantastic.
I know you're
a bit emotional. Rest of the night. Oh, I'm a wee bit. What about this tonight?
It's fantastic. You know, the whole town of Paisley has been waiting this for a hell of a long time. To see the boys like this, you know what it means to them. You know, we've got senior players in here and young players, and it's just fantastic.
Players have medals, of course. Fans have memories.
Absolutely.
This is what tonight's for.
That's what it's all about. Sure. They'll remember this for the rest of their lives. They'll remember names for the rest of their lives. And it's incredible. It's a lovely feeling.
And these players now, they're legends at the club.
They're legends. We've spoken about Frank McGarvey, Tony Fitzpatrick, Ian Ferguson. Now these guys get a chance to stand on the same plateau as them. Fantastic.
On my wildest dreams, signing with St Mirren, you know, I never thought this would have happened, to be honest, and for it to happen the way it did, you know, it's great. And obviously I had a bad injury at the start of the season, which was kind of a downer, but this makes up for it in millions.
What about this, the fans tonight?
They're incredible. They're incredible, absolutely amazing. And they were awesome today, and they really inspired us. And it looks like we're going to have thousands more of them walking the streets of Paisley.
Goodness.
It'll last for weeks, it'll last for weeks.
You look at these fans, they're 10, 12, 15 deep here down the either side of the bus. It's amazing.
Yeah, that's what it's for. And they're the most important people at any football club. And it's absolutely a privilege that we can bring this wonderful trophy back to them for the first time in the club's history. They invest so much financially, emotionally, and with their time at the football club. They've been starved their silverware for 26 years, so this is for them.
That was earlier on this evening. I think later on I might need a few subtitles to... fantastic stuff, though, isn't it?
Oh, it was great to see. I mean, big Stevie Thompson, I know well. I had him at Burnley and he was outstanding for me. And great to, you know, he'll lead the party tonight. There's no doubt about that.
I think he's conquered his shyness, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's overcome that. But he's very talented musically as well, as you know. So he'll be leading the sing songs, getting his guitar out. And there's no doubt. I think he said it'll last for weeks himself. And he's been known for when he goes out, he doesn't know the way home. So I think that's what will happen tonight.
Let's look back, Craig, on the key moments of the match. And I mean, Hearts were out of the blocks really impressively, weren't they? And they deserved to take the lead when Ryan Stevenson scored.
Yeah, it's a manager's dream, isn't it, to go off to start like this. This is a little bit like pinball. There's a couple of tasty challenges there, and Jim Goodwin goes in to try and clear the situation. But I think maybe St Mirren can look at this situation where they've got a lot of players round about the ball. Maybe should have stopped the shot getting away. But all credit to Ryan Stevenson. And was there a slight deflection? Maybe it just caught the the calf of one of the Sunderland players.
Yeah, Paul Dummett.
And it just goes into that far corner. But what a start as a manager at the sideline. They didn't just start away with that goal. I mean, in general, their pressing was excellent and they were in St Mirren's faces.
I think they'd earned that goal because of their start. They were really in the ascendancy early in that game. And we obviously, we spoke about the further chances they had to add to it. And they were really the dominant team at that point and looked all set to go on and win the cup.
Yeah, well, there were opportunities, weren't there? And the Hearts' manner of play, they were stopping St Mirren doing what they were doing, and they were creating chances. And they'll look back on the game now, Craig, and think these were the moments in which they could have killed it off.
Yeah, I mean, John Sutton has a really good chance there. Walker digs one out to the back post. And excuse me, looking at it there, if he goes back across the goalkeeper at all, it's a goal.
I think on another day he'll feel like Sutton would have feel he should score at the back post. It's a great cross. You see this here, I mean, for me as an old striker, I think he's got to be looking to get a touch on that. And any touch, there's no doubt that would have been a goal. So these weren't half chances that Hearts had. These were real, as far as I'm concerned, real goal-scoring opportunities to put the game to bed. They never took them. St Mirren hung in there, and the games can change.
And St Mirren equalised with pretty much their first decent passage of play.
Yeah, normally St Mirren do get their play going fairly early in matches, but, you know, both teams, I believe, are on the top, the bottom six of the SPL, which is hard to believe watching game. The quality of the goals, great striker play from Thompson into Teal, and what really unselfish play, you know. I mean, as a striker, I think he's shooting at goal, isn't he? You'd have shot at goal for sure, but...
Well, I would have scored as well, but, I mean, I've got to say... No, I think it's fair to say...
Firstly, onside.
Yeah, he's onside. I mean, Hearts, why they're trying to play offside there when there's no pressure in the initial pass, I don't know. But you're right, Gary Teal's awareness of where his teammate is. Goncalves has made up terrific ground with his pace, and that's still not an easy finish. He's got a lot to do. And that really gave St Mirren belief then. They were back in the game, getting to half-time level, as you know, and were a real platform to go on and give an inspired second-half performance, which they did.
And it's a double-edged sword, isn't it? Because it had an impact on Hearts as well.
I think we showed one picture earlier on, Stevenson walking off the field at half-time at one each,
shattered,
shaking his head.
Yeah.
You know, that was the kind of mental place that the Hearts were in.
It was a disbelief that they were drawing the game after having dominated.
And you and I know Danny's going in there at half-time saying, "You're beauty, we've got away with murder here in the first half." And his team talk is so easy, look.
I've got no doubts, as Craig said, Danny Lennon would have been saying, "Do you know what, we can't play as poorly as we've did there in the first half in terms of our quality of play, but we're still here. That's Hearts' best shot. If we raise this 10-15%, there'll only be one set of winners in the second half." And that's how it proved.
And Gary Locke's team talk is so completely different.
Yeah, he's going to lift him again, exactly.
Cathartic was pretty impressive from Stephen Thompson in his aftermatch interview. You'll not be saying that one tonight, I wouldn't have thought.
No, I
without
think
a great
when,
deal of difficulty.
Yeah, I think once he's a couple of beers, he'll struggle to say anything at all.
But 53 seconds after the restart, what a goal. Terrific movement, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. I mean, you see, again, St Mirren are comfortable in possession. I think that could have been a better header. But from this point on, they're comfortable with the ball. You can see there, you're only looking. It's a nice little weighted pass. And Tomo's movement's brilliant. Steps across the centre-back. And it's a great finish. He's got a lot of work to do. Arguably, Sutton probably had an easier chance in the first half. Tomo stepped in. That's a great finish.
And looking at it from the other point of view, looking at it from the defender's point of view, Hearts didn't press the ball at all in the wider area.
Yeah.
And Danny Wilson gets caught straight onto the ball rather than having an eye on the...
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, because I was always taught as a striker, as soon as I could see the defender's number, the defender didn't know where I was, and that's what happened there.
Yeah.
You know, he had no awareness of where Stevie Thompson was. He goes to look, by the time he looked, Stevie Thompson stepped in front of him, and it's a terrific finish in the top corner.
The point being, in the first half, Hearts were really at it,
yeah,
you know,
pressing.
And they weren't giving them time to play, and you saw from that situation there that Hearts weren't in their faces, and just that little fraction, that's all it needs, just a little bit of somebody switching off, and that's the result.
So many special moments in the game. One of them for Conor Newton, the Geordie boy. His first St Mirren goal is at Hampden, and it was brilliantly created and finished, wasn't it?
It was brilliant. The composure of the ball, I mean, a great way to pass. Again, Hearts have tried to play offside, which I can't believe. That's twice they've done it, and they've been punished with both goals. But it's a great way to pass. He's clearly onside. And what he does for me, which is, as a striker, I'd have probably taken another touch, but he hits it early and it gives the goalkeeper absolutely no chance. He strikes a great ball. I watched him against Celtic in the Scottish Cup tie that they narrowly lost. He had three or four shots from outside the box. He obviously strikes the ball well. And this is a wonderful strike right into the corner.
Yeah, and Jamie's setting himself, I'm sure, for Connor to take another touch.
Next touch, yeah.
And with him, and at that early, I mean, he's caught on his heels. And I mean, it's a great goal.
It's a great one. Again, St Mirren, I think, as we said before, when Hearts pressed them early in the game, it nullified the threat from their passing and movement. But when they stepped off, St Mirren were then allowed their passage of play. They've got great range of passing. They're comfortable with the ball. They'll take it in tight areas, play their little 1-2s, and they get real joy from that.
You worked with Ryan Stevenson at St Johnstone. It was almost at the end of the match, a one-man show on his behalf to try and take this into extra time.
Listen, you've got to feel for Ryan to have scored 2 goals. He probably had 4 on the day. He was outstanding today. I mean, you see here, that one, he's hit the bar. He's in there. I actually feel, and I've said this to him as a young player, I feel he probably should have had a better career. He's had a good career, but could be even better because he's got everything in his locker to be a top player. Pace, power and great quality. You see here again, he's not got a lot to do, but this is the only place it can go in, right in that corner.
And then after missing that first one, it's great, you know, going right back into a similar position and having the guts to
he's
go
got
and
that.
Score
he's got
goal.
Plenty of confidence. Yeah. He's a great lad, I've got to say that. And I'm just, you know, ultimately somebody's got to win and somebody's got to lose. But for what he contributed to that game, on any other day, that would have been a winning performance.
St Mirren thought they had it well under control at 3-1 up. Suddenly, it was a twitchy closing to the game for them, and Stevenson could so easily have scored again and taken this amazing final a step further.
Yeah, again, you know, this game was never over. You just had that feeling, even at 3-1, that there'd be more chances. And you know, a great strike at goal, pushed back into him again. And if that ball comes across the face of the goal, it can hit anybody, maybe ricochet into the goals, but... You know, all credit to him. I mean, if you want to call hitting the post on target, he's yeah. from tight areas, he's got the ball into a dangerous situation, an opportunity to score. So, I mean, he must be sick tonight. I saw it at half time in his face, but we didn't see his face at the end of the game, yeah. but I bet it was 10 times worse than it was at half time because I thought he had an excellent match.
For St Mirren, I mean, Craig was talking about both teams being bottom six. They're both bottom three. Only Dundee are below them. They produced that amazing final. St Mirren come out on top. It's their trophy. Can this be a platform, Owen, for them to do that little bit better next season?
I think it can be. I think what they have now, and we spoke about it before the semi-final, they've got a good mix now of experience and young players. Danny's actually worked the loan market very well with the two lads, you know, Newton and Dummett from Newcastle, who have come in and did very well. He's got some good young players, and young McGinn and a few others of that ilk. So I think when they're getting the balance right, it can really be the platform to really push on and improve the club. And really, I would imagine they want to be, you know, top six next year. They'll want to have runs in the cup because they've been used to it and enjoyed it. And it's a great feeling. I mean, I always love cup competitions, and I'm sure they do now as well.
Well done, St Mirren. And with they and Hearts involved in today's cup final, there were just the 4 games in the SPL.